Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Continuing the video series guiding the use of the MetaTrader 4 platform on IC markets. In this video, I will guide you through the operations to manage trading orders. In the trading process, order management is very important. Proper and appropriate order management will help you protect your capital better. And in the video, I will also guide you on how to set up trailing stop, which is a way for you to secure your profits in trading orders when the order is moving in the right direction.
Welcome to the IB Support Channel. This information channel guides you about the IC Markets platform. If you are new to IC Markets, please subscribe to the channel to receive the most useful information.
To perform the operation of managing trading orders, first, we will consider setting take profit or stop loss for trading orders. Setting take profit and stop loss is very easy. We just need to click on the order we have traded, then drag and drop it to the corresponding positions to get the take profit or stop loss position. This is for a sell order. When you click on the trading order and drag it upwards, it will be stop loss, and if you drag it downwards, it will be take profit. For a buy order, it will be the opposite. If you want to precisely adjust the take profit or stop loss position, we will double click on this trading order. Then we will precisely modify the information of those values in the corresponding fields. After modifying, we will click modify. Then these values will be changed according to what we have set. Next, when an order has been traded and active for some time, how do we partially close it? Partially closing an order here can be used in one of two cases. First, when we see the price moving against the trend we analyzed, and we feel that the probability of it moving in the correct trend is not very high, we can completely close the order immediately. You can close the entire order, or you can partially close the order in the case where the price moves in line with our analyzed trend. However, if we set the take profit quite far away, but there are resistance levels between the entry point and the take profit position, like this position for example, we are concerned that the price will hit this resistance level and bounce back. So, when the price reaches this resistance level, we will also partially close the order, and then we will adjust the remaining part of the order to ensure that we will make a profit on the order we have traded. So, to partially close an order, we will do the following. Open the terminal section. In the terminal section, double-click on the field at the very end, the field that shows the fluctuating amount of money. Double-click on it. Then, you will modify the trading volume. For example, this order I am currently trading 0.5 lots. I want to close 0.25 lots. So I will change this to 0.25 lots. Then I will click close. This means I have closed half of the order. You can see that the remaining volume of this order is only 0.25 lots. We note that we must double click on the last part. However, if we double click on the preceding fields, such as the take profit field, if you double click here, it will bring up a window for us to edit the take profit and stop loss values only, and we will not be able to partially close the order. If we double click directly on the order on the screen, it will only bring up the section for us to adjust stop loss and take profit. In the case where our currently trading order, the price has moved a certain distance. For example, the price has moved down to this position. I will remove this. So, I am afraid that it will bounce off here and continue to go up. So, what can I do? I can adjust the stop loss. I will drag and drop it to this position. When I drop it to this position, if the price reverses, our order will still be guaranteed to be profitable, or at least break even. If we have already closed half of the order, at least we have half of this profit, and then if it comes back and hits stop loss, our order will also break even, and we will not lose this order. So, that's how we manage in this case. This stop loss adjustment technique is a manual adjustment technique when we have time to observe the market. However, if the price has already moved in the direction we analyzed, and we want to automatically adjust the stop loss, we can use the trailing stop option. You can right-click on the order we are currently trading. Right-click in the terminal section. Select trailing stop. Then, You will select custom, or you can choose one of these values as well. I will choose custom. Next, I will set the number of points for trailing stop. For example, here I set 100 points. When I set the trailing stop value like that, the stop loss position will be displayed in yellow. This trailing stop will work as follows. When the product's price moves in the direction we analyzed, the stop loss position will always follow along. And when it follows, it will always maintain that distance, which is 100 points from the price position to the stop loss level. 100 points is equivalent to 10 pips. For example, if the price has moved down to this position, and I look back up 100 points, then the position of this stop loss line will move to the red line position. I'll adjust it a bit here, and it will move to the yellow line. This stop loss position will move to this position when the price reaches the level below. So, if the price has already moving in the direction we analyzed, then this stop loss position will move. However, in this case, the price is moving back against the trend we analyzed, so this stop loss position has not moved. It is still at the original position we set. When the price moves down to this position, this stop loss has moved to this position. And if by chance the price does not continue to move but turns back, this stop loss line will not move backward but will stay put. And if the price turns back and hits here, it means it has hit stop loss. And when it hits stop loss like that, we have secured a profit from here to here. So, from here to here is quite a lot already, more than 100 pips. In that case, we will no longer worry about the issue of the price reversing and causing our order to go into a loss. It will always ensure that our order is profitable. Therefore, this trailing stop has many interesting and good features that we can use. During usage, you should also note that trailing stop does not always maximize its advantages, as it also has disadvantages. For example, if the price has moved to this point and then reverses, if we do not set trailing stop and keep the stop loss above, then when the price reverses like that, it does not continue to go up but continues to go down like this. What does that mean? It means we could still have more profit, right? But if we use trailing stop, the stop loss position has already moved to the yellow line. And when the price reverses and hits our stop loss, then continues to go down, at that time, we will feel a bit regretful that we did not hold the order when the price was still moving like this. In general, each method has its own advantages and disadvantages. We just accept the pros and cons of the method we choose. So, we need to be very careful during usage. For MetaTrader 4, there is no function that allows us to close all open orders. For example, here I have two orders. So, when I want to close the orders, I will need to close them one by one, not all at once. If you access the CTrader platform, which is a more advanced platform, you will see that it has this function. I will introduce that to you when we get to that part. But here, if we want to close orders, we can only close them one by one. For example, I will close this order. I will close this order next, so I will click here. So, that's how we manage trading orders. Our trading orders will be moved to the trading history section when we have closed them. And in this trading history section, you can fully check and evaluate your trading orders to see if they are effective. And if you want to have more detailed analytical data about the orders you have traded, you can right-click on this trading history section and select Open History. Then, right-click again and select Save Detailed Report. You choose the location to save this report. After choosing the location to save the report, I will click Save. Here, you can see that my trading results will appear in a report table like this. Here, it will contain all the information about the orders I have traded. It will also have information about the win rate, loss rate, and what the maximum drawdown is, how the equity curve looks, and it has additional statistical data like this to help us better evaluate whether our trading orders are effective. Thus, I have now finished introducing to you some operations to manage trading orders on the MetaTrader 4 platform. I hope the information I provided is useful to you. Thank you for watching the video. If you find the video useful, please give it a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel releases them.